IoT has great opportunities, has also multiple challenges, and we should not neglect them, because those challenges that are around ethical, business and societal challenges are extremely important.
It's not only about a technological or data debate. It's much more. Because first of all, when you're talking about sensors and interfaces, you need to think that it's not only a device, it's not only a sensor, it's an architecture you have around it. And it means it's a governance of humans taking decision when it comes to these architectures.
This kind of concept of personal data, one that is really an underpinning of a lot of European and other law, has started to break down. And if I know 4 movies that you've rented on Netflix, I probably have approximately all of the movies that you've ever rented on Netflix. So every little thing you do reveals everything else you do. And so the question is, if this is the world we're heading to, what does this mean for data protection?
We're actually using modern cryptography techniques to provide ways of processing data in a privacy-preserving way. Of course, you know, there's no perfect solution to data protection, you know, as Paul very aptly pointed out, but there's a lot we can do to make the system make protections better than they are.
The benefit of the IoT is essentially we have the integration of the cyber world and the physical world. So we can think many examples of how this integration from the cyber world can benefit the physical world, and from the physical world how to benefit the cyber world.
What is Internet of Things? I assume you know you all are well aware. The way I see it is both a huge opportunity in functionality, convenience, stemming from the types of data that IoT devices can provide and the kind of functionality they can provide, but also it presents huge risks in terms of security and privacy.
It's going to give the opportunity to get very, very good understanding of the risk of the things that are producing the risks. But there is a big challenge with it because there is a strong privacy effect.
And I think it's hugely important that we all have to consider the risks imbalanced with innovation.
And it's not a technological issue. It's a question of asymmetry of information, it's a power issue, it's a question of the role of platforms, the importance of the cloud. So this is very important for us as well, and AXA Research Fund has decided to fund research on this topic.
I have to say this, to take this opportunity to thank AXA for the research fund for the generous support. The support is really unique in the sense that it gave us the opportunity and the means to collaborate with the best researchers in the world.
It was very interesting to learn from my academic perspective kind of the state of the art of what AXA is doing in applying new technologies.
I think it was a great opportunity to interact in a kind of practical way, but also a theoretical way.
We spend a lot of time thinking about data protection, data treatment, sharing data with the customers, being transparent about how data is being used, what data is being stored.
If we now look forward into innovation, we really need to look more in the academic world. And I'm very happy to see that this link between the academic world and the business world has taken place here. And I would really like to thank the 3 professors who have been here today, who have really helped us to do this. The Research Fund team have really contributed to make this discussion a very productive discussion, and I really hope that you have been thinking, been brainstorming about the risk of IoT, but in particular also about the opportunities. Ooh.